Wow, I just got fucking hit, dude. Yeah, dude, I was only a couple of minutes away from home and just minding my own business, and smack, I'm like, fuck, man, I instantly turned around and looked at dude in, like, disbelief. Like, did you just really freaking hit me? Did you just run into me, dude, while we're all just waiting to get off the freeway? Like, ridiculousness, man. And I don't know what he was doing. I'm assuming he was probably looking at his phone or something, because we were just kind of, like, stop and go on the off-ramp to pull onto the main road there. Just slammed me, man. So, yeah, I turn around and look back at him, and he's just looking at me. And I can see his girlfriend in the front seat, and you can tell she was all embarrassed. She's just like, dude, I can't believe my man just did that. And I'm like, I know. He's like, I can't believe your man did that either. And so I mimic over to him, like, we go, which way you want to go? And we go here, here. He's just like ignoring me. He's like doing the, like, I don't know if he was trying to act hard or if he was just like completely just like dumbfounded at what he just did or whatever. So I hung my head out the window and I'm like, you want to follow me over here, bro? And you want to follow me over here? Yeah. He's just like kind of like nods his head like, yeah, let's fucking go. You know, so we pull over to a truck stop just down the street, and I jump out, and he's looking at me, and he's just like not saying anything. And so I say, you know, everybody okay? You know, it's like everyone's good. Okay, let's look at the damage. And I look at the back of my car, and basically the only thing that happened was when he hit, he pushed my, like, the plastic shell of the bumper into, you know, whatever is back there in the back. You know, like, I'm sure there's like plastics and rubbers and styrofoam and steel that kind of make up the bumper, and it basically just like pushed the plastic into maybe something sharp on one side, and it like punctured a little hole, which just like cracked the plastic maybe an eighth of an inch. It was something really easy, or not easy, but it was something really basic, just a little break. And I'm like, okay, well, that sucks, because I hate it when my car gets damaged. I mean, even when I take dings from rocks, I'm always just like, god damn it. But it wasn't too bad. It wasn't something that I was worried about, like, oh geez, now I'm gonna have to go and like deal with the body shop for 2 weeks. And you know, and everyone's telling me, oh, you should go have it looked at, you should go have it looked at. And I'm still kind of up in fence about going and dealing with that. But I think it was all okay, but I'm undecided yet. I did get his info. But we then make our way over to look at his car, and the grill's all busted out, and the front lip, like the front end aero lip part of the bottom of his car was all cracked, and the paint was scuffed. And I'm like, dude, it was a Scion FRS, dude. And I'm like, wow, they don't make those very well, I guess, dude. They busted under just a little minor accident. I guess it just hit the right place or something. I don't know. It was kind of sad that mine had, like, no damage at all, but his did. And all this comes at the end of, like, this huge freaking bad luck streak that I've had lately, man. It's been unbelievable. I don't understand what I did to piss the world off, but apparently I did something. And I know some of you guys that follow the Accord Diaries know some of the mishaps, and others don't. And I'll just kind of brush up on them for you, I guess. Like the last 3 months, all this shit's gone down. So I'll just kind of start with, it's been a 3 month period, and these are all the things that have happened. So first started, it was my AC, a pebble or a rock on the highway punctured my condenser on my air conditioner in my car. So that went out, and it's so hot over here that I'm not going to drive my car without an air conditioner. So I got my AC fixed. That was $800 or $700. Yeah, $700. And then after that, you guys know my AC in my house went out, and that cost me, actually my insurance company covered that, but it still cost me $1,100 for permits and shit. Fucking California and its stupid ass bureaucracies. I had to pay $1,100 for permits and things to fix something in my own goddamn house. Drives me crazy, dude. I have to get permits to put a ceiling fan in. I have to get permits to replace toilets. I have to get permits to change electrical outlets. Like, it's just absolutely asinine, and it's bullshit, but it is what it is. So I pay those. What else? Excuse me. What else happens? I got locked, or my wife got actually locked out of our house the other day because the fucking doorknob broke. Like, the little button that you press down to open the front door, for those of you that have, like, the thumb button to press down, snap. So it was just flimsy. There is nothing there. And the locking mechanism was, like, stuck into the door, the door frame, or the frame, Jesus, frame, or the slot. So ended up having to, like, break the door and fucking, you know, sit there and work at getting that thing undone. So that was $150 because I had to fix all that. And then one of my quadcopters, like, I plugged it in one day, it just magic smoke, and the main board fried. So I was like, dude, all I did is plug the battery in. I hadn't even modified it or anything. It just burnt up. And I'm like, well, it was, you know, like, it's been through a lot. I beat the shit out of that thing. Like, that was really, truly the quad that I learned how to fly FPV on. So I buy a replacement quad and flew it 3 times a week later, and it freaking, wind caught it, and it blew into the neighbor's yard. It was some old lady who, she can't find it, she won't, like, it's gone, dude, it's just gone. So to replace that whole setup was like $150 or something. So that, and then, let's see, my grill, those of you guys who be grilling a street on Facebook and are familiar with my grilling videos and pictures and shit that I like to do, that grill actually stopped working. I can't get propane to the burners, and it just, like, I've ripped it all apart. I don't know what's happened. There must be a valve or a gasket that's just, like, shot. You can smell it and it won't get there. So I was like, fuck, man, after all these things have gone wrong, I'm not going to replace it now. And it's the end of summer, so I was like, I wasn't too worried about it. But at the same time, you guys know that I love to grill and I love hanging out in the backyard. So my grandmother-in-law actually gave me a hand-me-down. And I think I used it 3 times before that one broke. Like, the I can't get propane to the burner. The starter won't work anymore. I've dismantled it, taken it apart, and rebuilt it, and tried to figure out what was wrong with that. And normally I can fix things like this, and it's just faulty. I don't know, man. So I got 2 grills out. What else have we had? The wife knocked over her phone in the middle of the night on the nightstand and cracked the screen and fucked her phone all up. So we had to get her a new phone, which wasn't the end of the world because we're on the 1 year plan through Verizon. We just get, like, a new phone every year. So, but still, it was like, you know, it was more cash out of the pocket. What else? Oh, the wheel bearing on the Accord went out, which fucked up the alignment, which then fucked up the tires, and actually that all came down to Honda not rotating my tires for like 10,000 miles. Now that I think about it, I think that's really what had worn down the tires, but the wheel bearing definitely added to it. So I had to get new tires, which is $800. And God, I think there's more. I mean, other than being rear-ended yesterday, like, son of a bitch. Like, that was all so bad, man. It was just all these things, just one after another, just like boom, boom, boom. Oh, my garage door opener stopped working. Just all these things, man. It's just been a pain in the ass. I've been like, what did I do? But on a good note, I missed a deer by inches this morning in the same spot that I hit one when I first got the car. When I first got the car, I hit a deer, and it did like $4,000 worth of damage or something, like week 2 of having it or something. So maybe things are looking up. I missed the deer by literally inches, dude. I'm driving this morning and I see something kind of muffled in the roadway. I'm like, what is that? And then I, like, turn my brights on, and next thing I know, it's just like this deer running down the freeway, running right at me. And I just, like, give it one of these, like, wham, just turn just enough that I missed that thing by literally, it had to have been no more than like 12 inches at the very most, dude. I was like, holy crap. I was like, right after getting rear-ended, like, I'm going to actually have a real accident, and I'm going to freaking cream my car or something, you know? I give a fuck about the deer. I hate deer. But I love my car, so I was like, damn. So that happened this morning, and my wife just got a huge promotion, man. I'm still so proud of her. She's been busting her ass, and she's now the boss lady. She's the big boss lady, so that's a big plus, and things are maybe looking up, I hope. I hope this streak has been ended. You know, it's like, I don't know what kind of karma I got coming, but it's been really bad karma lately, it feels like. And maybe I'm just complaining and being a bitch, because normally things go pretty well for me. But, you know, it's just, there it is, man. It's one of those things. It's like, Jesus Christ. So anyway, dude, I got that little rear-end kiss yesterday, and I wanted to just kind of share it with you guys. You know, it's one of those where you're like, I record everything. I had to post it. You know, it's like just sitting there minding my own business, listening to some AC/DC, doing what I do. Until I was rudely interrupted by this fucking scion that gave me a little kiss. I mean, I get it. You know, I am a good-looking son of a bitch, so, you know, it happens. I'm just kidding. I'm just fucking around. But, yeah, so there it is, man. You guys saw it. By the way, I also found the clip of the Cadillac that I was talking about last episode. So, well, before I keep going, let's go ahead and show you guys that clip, because I told you if I found it, I would. So, here you go. So, there's the pull on the Cadillac. That guy had been fucking with me for miles. Just every chance he got, he would cut me off and then slow down and like stick me in traffic and just piss me off, man. Just over and over, this guy was just pissing me off, and I was trying to do the cool thing. It was late, I'm not trying to get myself in trouble. And then finally, right there, the freeway opened up, I'm like, fuck this dude, I'm running him. And dude, I was actually surprised he got pulled on, dude. I mean, I got a little jump on him, but there's no way he was catching me, dude. I was pulling farther and farther the further that I revved. You know, it was like my high end just had more than his for some reason, even though he had a turbo. I don't know. I guess it's all the way it's tuned, because, shit, my new truck, man, the twin turbo V6 on those Ford F-150s got so much torque, man. Like, oh, my God, I love the torque of those things. And, you know, I've always been one of those guys that's like, turbo, that's high-end power, you know. And, nah, man, it's, you know, it's, I mean, obviously I'm not an expert when it comes to cars, but they definitely tune those things up for some nice low-end torque, dude. So maybe the Cadillac just got more torque or something, but he got yanked on and fucking put in his place, so whatever. It is what it is, and I enjoyed it. So I'm building up another collection of clips for another highway pull montage, but I've only got like two or three right now, and I'm gonna need more than that. I'm gonna definitely need more than that. So anyway, after all that being said, what street been up to? Not much, man, just hanging out, doing my thing, you know, trying to stay busy. I try to get out and do things when I can. It's so hard with my job and working and commuting and coming home to, you know, the kids and doing homework and going to bed. And, you know, so I wake up so early, and now my schedule is going to change. So I got to start changing up the way I do stuff, and I got to stay up later here coming up, and next week I start, and it's going to be different. So my gaming schedule will change a little bit. My commute will actually be during the daylight in the morning and then dark at night now, which will be different. I'd rather drive it in the morning in the dark, because there's so few people on the road. But in the evenings, I'm not gonna have to worry so much about deer, because the deer aren't really out between like 5 and 7, man. Not around here anyway. They come out like between 1 and 6 in the morning. That's when it's like hazardous. So that'll be a big bonus. I mean, I'm really happy about the schedule change. There's a lot of bonuses to it. I should say bonuses. There's a lot of pros and cons, like there is with everything else. You know, some things I like, some things I don't. I like that I get to be with my kids in the morning, but I don't get to spend more time with them in the afternoon. You know, because in the morning, it's just like go. It's like hustle time, like breakfast, get dressed, make lunches, you know, out the door, let's go. And, you know, it's not quality time like in the evening when I can actually hang out with Isaiah and I can, you know, play video games together. We can go out and play some b-ball or, you know, something like that. Or my daughter and I play like a lot of Candyland and Chutes and Ladders, and we read books and, you know, things like that. Or she's like my little quad support system too. She likes coming with me and flying the quadcopters. And Isaiah's kind of just like, eh, whatever. But she actually really likes it. So I'm hoping Isaiah, I was hoping, was going to be my co-pilot and be the guy racing with me and stuff. But it's looking more and more like it might be Malia. So we'll see. Maybe Malia will be out there racing Tiny Whoops with me or, you know, all that thing. Dude, I've kind of given up on the 250s because you have to be certified now, and I'm actually studying to get my certification right now because I need it for my work, because we run commercial quads for land surveying in my office and orthogrammetry and aerial photos and things. But in the town I live in, we live within 5 miles of an airport, so that means that any time I want to go and fly, I have to call the tower and, like, you know, okay with them that I'm going to be flying over here at the school that I always fly at. It's just not going to work anymore. So it's becoming more of a pain in the ass, and the FAA has just been kind of screwing us left and right when it comes to the hobby. So I'm kind of sticking with micros now because I fly those anywhere. So you guys saw the video of me flying at the office the other day. That was awesome, dude. I had so much fun. In those corridors was just, it was awesome. It was like fluid and fast. It felt really fast because of the 90 degree angles and just bebopping along through there. So that was fun. So definitely be on the lookout for more micro videos. I think that's all I've really been posting lately. It's just because it's easier to get out and fly, and I can fly in the house if I want to. And winter's coming up, so everyone's kind of packing up the 250s and the 180s because you don't want them to get wet. Yeah, even if it's not raining and you crash in some wet grass, it could be a problem. So you got to really watch out for that stuff. So anyway, I'm on the last half of the commute. We'll go ahead and leave the video open for a minute just in case anything happens along the way. But more than likely, it's probably going to be smooth sailing. So I'm going to go ahead and sign off now. Thanks for watching, everybody. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already. If anything good happens at the end of this commute, I'll go ahead and post it into the end here as bonus footage. So thanks for watching, everybody. I really appreciate your support. Those of you guys who help support the channel by liking and commenting and participating, you know I love you guys and I appreciate your support. So thank you very much. And any new subs, dude, you know, you guys got a lot to catch up on. So be sure to check out Streets Hidden Gems. Check out my FPV videos and check out all my Let's Plays that I have on the channel. There's a lot to look through. And I just got tons and tons of content. Over 1,000 videos of epic quality. Thank you so much, guys. See you next time.